No, not really.
My face, it's swollen.
Yes, everyone loves substance abuse, but no one wants to do anything about it. Tonight, a searing look at a major problem.
Tell you what, baby. Come over to my house, listen to a little music, I'll put in Octopussy, and after that, who knows?
Yeah, I don't live too far from here.
Hop, skip, and a jump, you know what I'm talking about, sweet baby? Yeah. Let's go. I got the movie all set. That was excellent, baby. Wonderful. But I'll tell you what, I got a split.
So long! People are waiting.
How do you choose a date? Whose company would you enjoy? Well, one thing you can consider is looks. What about Anne? She knows how to have a good time and how to make the fellow with her relax, have fun too. Yes, that's what a boy likes. He wants to know he's appreciated. Anne would be fun on a date. So Woody decided he'd ask Anne for this first date. But just how should he ask her? And what if she refused? No, it won't be easy asking for that first date. Just like that. After all, a girl likes to know you've had a good time.
This is not really what I expected, but I guess it never really is with a blind date, so I expected that maybe we would go to a bar, but this is nice. So, how long have you lived here? 4 years? That's nice, I think. So what do you do? What do you do for a living?
But when you're having so much fun, time goes all too fast. Well, it's the time Anne had set for getting home. And now, good night. The end of a perfect evening. But how do you say good night?
Well, you know, I've never really been on a blind date before, so it's new to me, I guess.
Tell me, what can I do to make you comfortable?
I'm fine just sitting here.
I could get you another chair. You want to sit on my lap, doll?
No, I do not want to sit on your lap.
I want to touch my whiskers. Go ahead, touch my whiskers.
Say, here's an idea.
The sketch is going nowhere. Let's just end this thing.
Drugs were becoming Marty's whole life. He was abnormally sleepy, losing weight, cross, irritable, fearful that the puncture marks on his arms would be discovered. His former friends now let him strictly alone.
This is Chad Douglasson reporting from Eatontown, New Jersey. A new wave of terror has struck the Garden State. It's unknown what the terror is, but it is known that the terror is tremendous. As you can see, the sky behind me is alight with pure, frightening terror. I've got no reports on what the terror is. All I can tell you is that I'm terrified.
Department of Continuous Awareness presents Paranoia Friend.
Are you assailed by voices at night commanding you to kill for the sake of some long-dead god? Does relentless fear prevent you from getting out of bed in the morning? Then you might be suffering from what some doctors call paranoia when you're not around to hear them. Yes, strange voices beyond our control are working against us at all times. Did I say that? Did you think I did? This is Private Wiggins, dishonorably discharged some time ago for a crime he thinks he didn't commit. After years of insomnia, he's finally deranged enough to do something dangerous. Uh-oh, Wiggins. Who are those people? Are they talking about you? Do they know? Do you know? Well, maybe you better get a closer look. Look at them.
Look at him. He's disgusting.
Terrorists.
He's a wretch.
How hideous.
I've never seen such filth.
They're everywhere.
Private Wiggins must present a discomforting sight to those sane enough to pity him. But should we pity the mentally ill? Science tells us to shun them. Religion tells us to embrace them. Speaking of science, it doesn't take Einstein to determine that Private Higgins must pay a price for his hostility.
No, I'm not knocking your lawn, man. I think it's a nice lawn and everything. I'm just saying that if you don't take care of that, like, right away, there's going to be hell to pay because... That shit,
you can tell,
that,
though.
That shit proliferates right, and if you don't take care of it.
You can, tell that I've been taking care of it.
No, dude.
Come on.
Yeah.
That's a lot of love in there. I mean, this man
look
is
what I got. Look at,
clearly paying attention.
I got this happening. Kind of shit happening all the time.
I think that guy used to live in our neighborhood.
Oh, yeah, that was the guy who lived on the payments from the government welfare or something.
Yeah.
Kind of not right in the head.
He yelling at us?
Yeah, whatever. So what did you use Miracle-Gro on this, or was this just your own urine?
Nah, I just water that. I just come across some water.
That's pretty good.
And now I got a lot better. It's all green.
Yeah, but you see this
on account of the rain.
This is crap ass right here. You got to get this out of here, ASAP.
It's a real nice job, though, you gotta admit. I mean, he put a lot of love and attention into that.
Hey, old man. Hey, old man, you see the end of a sketch come by here? It's about this tall?
No. No, was it funny?
Not particularly.
No, I didn't see it.